So I mentioned that, you know, one of the implications of Moore's Law is more and more embedded software. And it's a real challenge for the system designers building those systems to verify and test this increasing software content. So here to talk about how graphical system design is helping to address that challenge, I'd like to bring up from our real-time test group, Senior Product Manager Chris Washington and System Engineer Stephen Barrett. Nice. I like it. Instead of entry music, you get engine sounds?
Absolutely, Eric. That is some extreme engineering. And in fact, more specifically, that's the sound of a Formula One racing machine screaming across a track at nearly 200 miles per hour.
Okay, I know you're kind of a gearhead, and probably some people in the audience are, but if you're not, you're going to talk about engines. So can you give a quick primer to the rest of us on how an internal combustion engine works?
Certainly. So at the highest level, an internal combustion engine will mix air and fuel inside of a cylinder that's compressed with a piston. Now, when this compressed mixture is ignited, the piston converts the energy from the combustion into mechanical power that's delivered to the vehicle powertrain system. Now, after that combustion is complete, the piston is shoved back into the cylinder to remove the gases resulting from the explosion, and then this cycle will repeat itself. What's really impressive is that this cycle can repeat itself as many as 300 times in a single second in a typical passenger vehicle across six cylinders. But even more impressive than that is that this process can repeat itself as fast as 1,200 times per second in a Formula One race engine like the one we just heard.
Very cool. I could just sit there and watch that animation.
It's really
pretty cool. So, but we're talking about software. So what's the role software plays?
Sure. So engineers will use software to actually tune or optimize the performance of an engine around a combination of goals for power, fuel economy, or emissions. Now, in order to do this, the software will measure operating characteristics or parameters of the engine, such as the engine speed, the combustion performance in the previous cycle, or the amount of power that's being requested by the driver. The software then takes this information about the system and uses that to adjust the way it controls the engine in the next cycle, such as changing the amount of fuel or the timing of its ignition.
So you're taking measurements and you have closed loop response in less than a millisecond. I'm pretty sure I know of an architecture that addresses that challenge. So how are our products used in these applications?
Well, it'd be actually a lot easier to show you in our smart car here, Eric.
Back to the smart car, pretty close to F1, right?
Yeah, it's pretty close, and while it may not be a pristine racing machine, the engineering principles are still very similar from the software perspective. So in this demonstration, we're going to use a compact Rio to actually change the way the engine operates by controlling the engine with the software.
Okay, let me pause there for a second, because we just showed a standalone compact DAC that was used for in-vehicle data logging. Now we want to actually directly control the engine, so we need to do measurements and closed-loop response, and that's a job for Compact Rio.
Exactly right. So in this particular demonstration, we have LabVIEW running on the Compact Rio FPGA. And on there, it's measuring the mechanical or physical position of each piston inside the cylinder with microsecond resolution. It's then taking these measurements and using them to initiate the fueling task that are being calculated and adjusted on the fly by LabVIEW running on the Compact Rio microprocessor. Now, in order to initiate these fueling tasks, we're using the Driven C-Series modules for engine control to effectively allow us to connect LabVIEW directly to the engine through the port fuel injectors that are feeding the fuel to the cylinders. Why don't you hop in and I'll show you how we can control this engine and improve its performance with LabVIEW. All right, why don't you rev that baby up there, Eric? And what you should see here now is live in-cylinder combustion data on the screen. And in the PV diagram, we can see the area under the curve changing as he applies more power with the throttle. So hold it at a constant RPM for me there, and we're gonna have Steven here switch the control strategy for just one of the cylinders. And so when he clicks that on, we're gonna change the goals for that, and then we're gonna see how software can and change and improve the performance of that particular cylinder there. Great, Eric. So that's just one example of how engineers will use software to improve or adjust the mechanical performance of engines to their particular design goals.
Okay, so these systems are getting more and more embedded software, but at the same time, there's not a lot of tolerance for bugs when you're driving down the highway at 60 miles an hour.
That's right. So I think everybody in this room is familiar with the challenges of developing software. But when that software is connected to a physical, mechanical system, the consequences of a defect can be much more serious.